This Real Life Lore video is made possible by Tab for a Cause. Install their free browser extension by clicking the link in the description to help with hurricane disaster relief across the United States and elsewhere. Hurricanes, cyclones, and typhoons are some of the most destructive natural disasters that occur on our planet. Hurricane Katrina in 2005 caused over $105 billion in damages, and Hurricane Sandy in 2012 caused over $74 billion in damages. The amount of damage caused in North America and the Caribbean by this most recent hurricane season in 2017 will likely be unprecedented. But what if there was a way to destroy a hurricane before it could actually make landfall and cause any damage? Various theories have been proposed throughout history of ways to do this, but perhaps the most outlandish idea is to fire nuclear weapons into a hurricane. So, would this actually work? And what would actually happen if we ever decided to try it out? This idea has actually been around for quite some time. A meteorologist named Jack W. Reed suggested nuking hurricanes to destroy them as early as 1959. Reed noted that whenever a hydrogen bomb exploded, they would lift an enormous column of air up to 20 miles high into the sky afterwards. With this in mind, he speculated that a submarine armed with nuclear weapons could travel underwater through a hurricane and into the eye of the storm. Once inside of the eye, the submarine would launch multiple nuclear missiles that would detonate at the surface. The idea was that most of the warm air inside of the eye would be blasted out above the storm, while cold and more dense air would fill in and replace it, which would reduce the wind speed and therefore power of the hurricane. There were multiple problems with this theory, however, the first being that it wouldn't work. Hurricanes are ridiculously powerful events, and even average ones release 600 trillion joules of energy every single second. That's the equivalent to 10 Hiroshima-scale atomic bombs blowing up every second. In a single day, an average hurricane will release more energy than all of the electricity consumed by the United States in 2009. The most powerful nuclear device ever tested by humanity was the infamous Tsar Bomba at 50 megatons of explosive power. But that wouldn't even come close to matching the energy release of a hurricane. To match the energy release of a hurricane in a single day, you would have to detonate 238 Tsar Bombas inside of it, which would have the unfortunate side effect of destroying all of human civilization in the process. Even if you just detonated one, the radioactive fallout would be an additional severe problem that would get carried by the trade winds and cause horrible environmental damage, possibly costing more than the hurricane would have done anyway in the first place. The final obstacle to ever attempting this, though, is a legal one. The Peaceful Nuclear Explosions Treaty, signed by both the United States and the Soviet Union in 1990, limits the use of nuclear weapons for non-military purposes to just 150 kilotons. And considering how puny the 50 megaton Tsar Bomba is compared to a hurricane, this literally wouldn't do anything. The answer to the question of what would happen if we nuked a hurricane is probably nothing. Some scientists even theorize that it may cause the storm to grow even stronger, but it certainly wouldn't destroy it unless we were willing to destroy the whole world with it. Nobody ever took Reed up on this idea, thankfully, and with our technology today, the only things that we can really do to fight against hurricanes is to either run away or bunker down in shelter. As many of you probably know, I live in Texas, and the recent hurricane here in Houston has caused a truly biblical amount of destruction. Hurricane Harvey is estimated to have caused between $70 billion and $190 billion worth of damage, which could make it the costliest hurricane in American history. 30,000 people are still displaced from their homes here, and this isn't even to mention the humanitarian disaster that is currently unfolding in Puerto Rico in the aftermath of Hurricane Maria, and the incredible destruction in Florida as a result of Hurricane Irma. Added up together, this hurricane season will likely be the costliest in all of world history. But you can help entirely for free right now. It only takes 2 seconds to install the Tab for a Cause extension for your web browser. And when you install this extension, Tab for a Cause will donate to a charity of your choice every time you open a new tab. This doesn't cost you anything, which means that you can help assist with hurricane relief efforts or any other charitable missions right now while you're browsing the internet. Tabbers have already raised over $400,000 for charity through the extension, so you can follow this link on screen or click the link in the description to begin helping for whatever cause you want to be supporting. Save the Children is a particular charity that I support through the extension that is directly helping children in Puerto Rico after Hurricane Maria. So why not join me for free right now and click the link in the description to begin your own support.